Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. Today, in our series of basic math concepts, we'll talk about the notion of unit digit. Every once in a while, in the exam, whether you're preparing for GRE, or GMAT, or SAT, or SAT, any of these exams, every once in a while, you'll come across a problem where they will ask you to identify simply the unit digit of a given quantity. They're not expecting to solve the whole problem and tell us exactly what the quantity is. We just have to identify the unit digit. For example, here, the very first problem says, which of the following cannot be the unit digit of 43 raised to n? Let's find out. Shall be 43 raised to n? Here are the five answer choices. 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. And our job is, which of the following cannot be the unit digit of 43 raised to n? Let's find out, shall we? We know 43 raised to first power, of course, ends in a 3. So obviously 3 is not the answer, because question here is which the following cannot be. What about 43 squared? 43 squared, if we were to multiply 43 by 43, so we know now that 43 raised to 1 will end in a 3. Right there. What about 43 squared? Again, we don't have to figure out what 43 times 43 is. We simply have to realize that 43 times 43, whatever it is, must end in a 9, because the unit digit is simply 3 times 3, which means 43 squared will end in a 9. 9 cannot be the answer. How about if we were to multiply one more time, which will give us 43 cubed. This should say 43. It should give us 43 cubed. What do you suppose 43 cubed will be? Will end in? Let's find out, shall we? Again, 43 cubed is simply whatever this quantity was times 43. All we have to look at is the unit digit, which is 9 times 3. 9 3 is a 27. It will end in a 7, which means 7 is not the answer. The question is, how far do we have to go? 43 cubed will end in a 7. Question is, how far do we have to go? How long do we have to keep on going? Well, we'll find out in a second. As soon as we hit a 1, that's your cue that the cycle is going to begin to repeat. Because if you hit a 1, then 43 times something that ends in a 1, if there's a quantity above it which ends in a 1, and if you multiply it by 43, well, it will end in a 3 again. And the cycle will begin all over again. Let's keep on going, shall we? Let's find out what happens. 43 raised to 4. Let's multiply it by 43 one more time. Oh, what do you know? 7 3s are 20. 7 3 is a 21. Oh, there you go. 43 raised to 4 will end in a 1. And as soon as we see a 1, that's it. That's the end of the story. It will repeat the cycle, because if you were to go one more time, times 43, that will end in a 3. And then 3 times 3 will end in a 9, and so on and so forth. That is our cycle. 3, 9, 7, 1, 3, 9, 7, 1, so on and so forth. So we know that it can end in a 3, we can end in a 9, it can end in a 7, it can end in a 1. Question was, which of the following cannot end? If you have a quantity 43 raised to a power, it cannot end which of the digits? The answer is 5. It will never end in a 5. It will never end in a 5. Let's do one more, shall we? The next problem is very similar to what we just did here. Here, instead of asking which of the following cannot be, here they're asking us the next problem, number 2. They might ask you the same question a little bit differently, by saying, what is the unit digit of, say, 43 raised to 43. We don't have to do the work again. We just did the work. We just found out that the cycle was 3, 9, 7, 1. That was the cycle, wasn't it? We just found out that was the cycle. Of course, we had to do this work. Once we have identified the cycle, we figure out how many bits are in the cycle. There are 4 parts to it, which means every 4 parts it will repeat the cycle. 43 raised to 43 is simply 43 raised to 40 plus a 3. You agree? 43 raised to 40 will put us through 10 complete cycles, because each cycle is made up of 4 parts. 3, 9, 7, 1, 3, 9, 7, 1, 3, 9, 7, 1. And so on and so forth. We'll go through it 10 times, because 10 times 4 is 40. After we have done so, in other words, 43 raised to 40 will end in 1. Let's create this part so it doesn't confuse us. Let's put it here. 3971 was the series. You have to remember that. 3971. So we know 43 raised to 40 will end in a 1 because that's the end of the 10th cycle. We have to go up to 43. Well, that's very simple. We have to go 3 more. So here we go. 1, that's 41st, 42nd, 43rd. 43 raised to 41 will end in a 9. And 43 raised to 42 will end in a 7. Will end in a 7. Oh, I made a mistake because I wasn't... Oh, that was 40. That was 40 actually. That was 40. This is wrong. This is all wrong, which is why I didn't want to do it in so much detail. Keep it simple. This is 40. 41 should have been 3. 41 should have been 3. Let's not explain it in too much detail, because when you try to explain every nitty-gritty detail, every annoying step in excruciating detail, it just gets too complicated. It's just 40, which will put us through 10 more cycles, which will put us through 10 cycles, and we'll have to go 3 more. 3 more is right here. 1, 2, 3. It will end in a 7. Question was, what's the unit digit of 43 raised to 43? The answer is 7. The answer is 7. The answer choices were same as before, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Number 3. Why don't you do the number 3 yourself? Why don't you do number 3 by yourself? Here's the question. The question is, what is the unit digit of 12 raised to 4 times 19 squared times 33 raised to 3? What's the unit digit of this quantity? Let's find out, shall we? 12 raised to 4, let's work on that first. 12 raised to 4 is very simple. 12 times 12 will end in a 4. We can multiply by another 12, that will end in an 8. 4 times 4, 2 is 8. So we are up to 12 cubed. This was 12 squared. This is 12 cubed. We have to keep track of it so that we don't make a mistake. We have to do one more 12. And that 8 times 2 is 16, that will end in a 6. In other words, 12 raised to 4 will end in a 6. Let's find out 19 squared. 19 squared is very simple. 19 times 19 is 19 squared, and that will end in a 1. 9 9 9 9 is 81. It will end in a 1. What about 33 to the third? Very simple again. 33 times 33. 3 times 3 is 9. It will end in a 9. 33 squared. 33 squared will end in a 9. Of course, there are some digits here which we do not care for. Let's do one more time, 33. And that will give us 33 cubed. 33 cubed. I'm going to erase this x here because I find them annoying. If you multiply that quantity, this quantity, 33 times 33, whatever it is, it ends in a 9. And if you were to take that quantity and multiply by 33 one more time, the unit digit is going to be 9 times 3. 9 3 is at 27. And the question is, what's the unit digit of this quantity? Unit digit of this quantity is simply going to be 6 times 1 times 7. The unit digit of this quantity is going to be the unit digit of this quantity right here. 6 times 1 times 7. 6 times 1 times 7 is 42. And therefore, again, I did not give you the answer choices. I should have given the answer choices. It's too late now. The answer is 2. The unit digit of given quantity is 2. Not that it makes any difference now, but in case you were curious, the answer choices were 2, 3, 6, 7, and 9. Of course, these answer choices are there for a reason. They're not just put there haphazardly. They're there for a reason. Let's do one more. This is number 3. Do the next one yourself. What's the unit digit of 27 raised to 37 plus 37 raised to 27. And this time I won't forget the answer choices. A, B, C, D, E. 0, 1, 3, 7, and 9. Do it yourself. See what you can do here. Well, first thing you have to figure out is the cycle, the pattern. Lucky for us, they both end in a 7, so we won't have to do twice the work. Once we figure out the cycle for 7 here, that's the same cycle that's going to happen here. Let's find out what the cycle is, shall we? Let's find out what the cycle is. 27, of course, 27 raised to 1, it ends in a 1. 27 raised to 1 will end in 1. What about 27 times 27? 27 squared is going to be 7 times 7. 7 sevens are 49. It will end in a 9. 27 raised to 2 will end in a 9. We have to keep on going until we hit a 1. Once we hit a 1, that will be the beginning of the other cycle. Times 27 again. 9 sevens are 63. That will end in a 3. And then finally, one more time. Well, I shouldn't say finally, I shouldn't have given it away. We multiply by one more time 7, it will be 3 times 7, which is 1. Which tells us that our cycle is going to be 7, 9, 3, 1. 7, 9, 3, 1. That's our cycle. 7, 9, 3, 1. 27 raised to 3 will end in a 3, and 27 raised to 4 will end in a 1. It should say 7. 27 raised to 1 ends in a 7, not a 1. I have to learn to pay attention. 27 raised to 1 will end in a 7. 7, 9, 3, 1. Cycle is made up of 4 parts again. We're looking for 37, but that's very simple. 27 raised to 37 is same as 27 raised to 36 plus 1. My handwriting is getting quite atrocious. 27 raised to 37 is same as 36 plus 1. Why 36? Because 36 is a multiple of 4. So that will give us 9 complete cycles. After we have finished 9 complete cycles, we have still one more to go. So 9 complete cycles will take us to 1. We have one more to go, which means we'll end up at a 7. 7, 9, 3, 1. We'll do it 9 times. That will be the 36th here. We need 37, which will be the 7. So this guy ends in a 7. Let's make a note of it. This guy ends in a 7. What about 27? Well, 27 is very simple. The fact that it is 37 instead of 27 really doesn't play any role. It really doesn't play any role because we are not interested in what that quantity is. We are interested in the fact that it's the power of 27. But since it's 37, we're going to change it to 37. And now, we are interested in 27. What's the closest multiple of 4 that you can find to 27? It'll be 24. 24 plus 3. That tells us that 24 would be 6. 6 fours are 24. Doesn't really matter how many cycles we have, that's not relevant here. But we'll go through 6 complete cycles. That will bring us to 6 complete cycles. And after we have done 6 complete cycles, in other words, 37 raised to 24 will end in a 1. 37 raised to 25 will end in a 7. 37 raised to 26 will end in a 9. And 37 raised to 27 will end in a 3. In other words, we have to go 3 more after we have finished our cycle. We have 3 more to go, which is 7, 9, 3. This guy will end in a 3. This quantity will end in a 3. Since this quantity ends in a 3, and this quantity ends in a 7, when you add the two quantities together, it should end in a 7 plus 3. 7 plus 3 is 10, therefore it will end in a 0. It will end in a 0. let's do one last one, shall we? One last one, number 5, very last one. If you want to give it a try yourself, you can try it yourself. See what happens. Again, the question is, oh, this is, it doesn't ask us what's the unit digit. This is a different question. You need the room. This was question number 4, not 3. This is a little bit different. Let's see what we can do here. Question is, this is number 5. What is the remainder when 2 raised to 125 is divided by 5? And the answer choices are A, B, C, D, and E. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you want to give it a shot, I'll give you 2 seconds. I'll get out of your way so that you can have an unobstructed view of the problem, and then try it yourself. Pause the video, do it yourself, and once you have done so, compare your work with the work that you and I will do together in a few seconds time. Okay, here we go. Here's the question. Question is very simple, very straightforward question. Question simply is, what is the remainder when 2 raised to 125 is divided by 5? But here we go. Very first thing we have to realize is that if you are dividing a quantity, it doesn't matter which quantity it is, if you're dividing any quantity at all, if you're dividing a quantity by 5, any quantity divided by 5 cannot result in a remainder of 5. It cannot run in a remainder of 5. It's like proudly telling somebody that 15 divided by 5 is 2 times with a 10 and a remainder of 5. This is nonsensical. This is nonsensical. I don't know why we're turning into a grammar lesson here, but nonsensical is the adjective. Adjective of what? Nonsensical is an adjective of the noun. What's the noun of nonsensical? Nonsense. I don't know how to spell it, but nonsense is the word. Nonsense is the noun, and the adjective of nonsense would be nonsensical. What's the adverb? The adverb would be nonsensically. He was speaking nonsensically. Do you understand? His speech was nonsensical. His hypothesis was nonsensical. His theory was nonsensical. His idea was nonsensical. We don't say his idea was nonsense. In which case you will need an article by saying his idea was a nonsense. But it was better to say his hypothesis was nonsensical. Adjective. That's nonsensical. You cannot have a remainder of 5 when we're dividing something by 5. That's just silly. That's just damn silly. Let's find out, shall we? What's going on here? Let's find out. There has to be some pattern here. Our job is to find out the pattern. So let's begin then. 2 raised to 1 is 2. And what do you suppose will give us a remainder when we divide 2 by 5? I left no room here. I should have left the room here. 2 raised to 1 is 2, and the remainder would be what? When you divide 2 by 5, how many 5 does 2 have? 2 has no 5s. 2 has no 5s, and then we have a remainder of 2. We have a remainder of 2, assuming that we are not doing decimals, you understand? So that's the remainder of 2. 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 2 is 4, and again, if you divide by 4, how many 5 does 4 have? 4 has no 5s. 4 has no 5s. We have a remainder of 4. It will go 0 times. 2 raised to 3 is 8, and 8 divided by 5, 8 divided by 5, I'm not going to do everything now, but you get the idea. 8 divided by 5 will have a remainder of 3. Let's keep on going. 8, 2 raised to 4 is 16. 16 divided by 5 will have a remainder of 1. Voila, we hit a 1. As soon as we hit a 1, you know that the pattern is going to repeat. I'm looking for my cap that I just dropped from my marker. It's way over there, I'll get it later. It will repeat the pattern. And if you don't believe me, try it out one more. 2 raised to 5 is 32. And 32 divided by 5 will be 30 with a remainder of 2. It repeats the pattern. The next one is going to be 64. The next one is going to be 64, and 64 divided by 5 will have a remainder of 4. The next one after that is going to be 128. 128 will have a remainder of 3. I was looking at 8, I freaked out. 128 will have a remainder of 3, because 125 is divisible by 5 with a remainder of 3. It will repeat the pattern. So now we know our cycle. Our cycle is very straightforward, very simple. Our cycle again is made up of 4 parts. 2, 4, 3, 1, 2, 4, 3, 1, 2, 4, 3, 1, that's all. So it's going to go, keep on going. Now let's see what we can do with 125. How many complete cycles do we have in 125? 2 raised to 125 can be written as 120 plus 4 plus 1. I could have written that as 124, but this makes it easy for me to see. It makes it easy for me to see that 120 is divisible by 4, is evenly divisible by 4. So we'll have 30 complete cycles here. 12 divided by 4 is 3. 12 divided by 4, because there are 4 parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we'll have 30 complete cycles here. We'll have 31 cycles in next 31st cycle here. So we'll have 31 complete cycles. In other words, 2 raised to 124, 2 raised to 124 would have ended in 1. That would have been the end of the complete cycle. But since we have 2 raised to 125, we have to go one more, and one more will take us to 2. 2 raised to 125, when it's divided by 5, will end in a 2. Will end in a 2. That's all for today. Bye now.